This is Diane Miller for the Mike Elliott Show. Good morning. Mike has the day off today, but I'm here to keep you company on WMWM with some great music for your Sunday morning. Mike Elliott has a day off. I'm Diane Miller, spending a Sunday morning together with you. It's nice to have you here with us. Thank you for listening.
WMWM is now proud to present, through the miracle of radio and the speed of the turntable, this big hit song.
It's going to be a beautiful day today. Here's a check on the complete weather forecast from WMWM. Partly sunny and mild today, highs in the mid-50s. Tonight, clear with lows in the mid-30s. Tomorrow, continued partly sunny with high temperatures in the low 50s. That's a check on the weather forecast. Now back to more music on the Mike Elliott Show. I'm Diane Miller.
Bob Nelson in for Mike Elliott on the Mike Elliott Show. With oldies and contemporary hits. Are you having a cup of coffee right now? I have a little thing I'd like to read you. This is from the National Enquirer. I know you're laughing when you hear that, but some of their stuff is probably true, and this article certainly sounds true. It says, you need only one cup of coffee in the morning to get you going, says a researcher. You will remain alert for several hours by drinking just one cup of coffee, said Judith Wortman, a brain researcher at the Mass Institute of Technology. For the average person, the caffeine in coffee has an immediate stimulating effect, and to derive the stimulating jolt of coffee, you need only drink one cup. But drinking too much coffee may make you nervous, as those commercials with Robert Young used to say. She suggests you drink one cup of regular coffee in the morning and one for a pick-me-up around 3:30 or 4 p.m. The rest of the day, switch to decaffeinated coffee. Small amounts of caffeine have little effect on heavy coffee drinkers, so they may have to wean themselves slowly back to one or two cups a day, according to Wortman. Right now, here's Dexy's Midnight Runners. Let's hear a little bit of that Irish fiddle. Come on, Eileen. Or as the joke goes, what do you call a girl with one leg longer than the other? Eileen. Get it? Okay, no more attempts at humor, I promise.
Come on, Eileen. Oh, I swear, I believe at this moment.
Let's swing back to the year 1971 right now, and a guy who was born under the name Stephen Giorgio. He is now known under the name of Yusuf Islam, I believe, but everyone knows him as Cat Stevens. This is a song called Peace Train. By the way, if you tuned in for Powerline, Powerline will not be on this week, but it will return next week at its regular time, next Sunday morning at 9:30. It will return next week.
Now I've been happy lately, thinking about the good things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, I've been smiling lately, dreaming about the world at one. Someone like you makes it easy to give. Don't you kiss me once or twice? Tell me that it's nice and in you.
That's a guy named Dwight Yoakam. And I played that because it's a really good song, and it's an Elvis Presley song. I don't know who else did it, but that's Dwight Yoakam and a great version of Little Sister. Also in there, Rod Stewart with a song written by Tim Hardin, Reason to Believe by Rod Stewart from the album Every Picture Tells a Story. It is about 5 minutes past 10 o'clock. Bob Nelson here until, I almost said midnight, because usually I'm on at night, but I'll be on till noon, and then Mike Birmingham should be in for the Hot Box as we switch to R&B. But right now we're playing oldies and current hits right here on the Mike Elliott Show. I'm filling in for Mike Elliott this week. Mike is sort of tired and beaten out. He's been working real hard, and he's taking a week off, but he will be back next week, and I'm on this week. My name is Bob Nelson, and I welcome your request at 745-9170. Sometimes we'll have a record and it will just disappear. I mean, I don't know, it must have got lost. Oh, speaking of which, here's the J. Giles Band. A big hit for them back in 1974. I think it was their first top 40 hit, as a matter of fact, from the album Nightmares Must Have Got Lost.
Never thought about tomorrow. Seemed like a long time ago. How could I be so blind, baby? Not to see you were the one. I must have got lost. I must have got lost. Must have got lost somewhere down the line. Ooh, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. I've been dreaming for too long. Wake up, I'm next to you.
Going out by request to Salem, that's Graham Parker and Wake Up Next to You. And the J. Giles Band, starting us off, Must Have Got Lost from 1974 and the album entitled Nightmares. My name is Bob Nelson, and I'm filling in for Mike Elliott on The Mike Elliott Show this week, WMWM in Salem.
Hiyo, everyone. Hank the Engineer here. Listen, it's been brought to my digression that you clowns ain't been taking advantage of the WMWM bumper sticker giveaway. It's the deal of the century, and it's making me sick. You hear? Sick. Tell them about it, Elmer.
Well, when I'm walking through the forest hunting for silly rabbits, I take them and stick them with a WMWM bumper sticker. Ain't that right, Marty?
Well, I want to find a WMWM bumper sticker and stick it on the planet Earth.
Get your WMWM bumper sticker now. Send your name, address, and age on a self-addressed stamped envelope to WMWM Salem, 352 Lafayette Street, Salem, Mass., 01970. Attention, bumper stickers.
You earthlings make me so angry.